Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today, fellas, today we have very, very good game, okay? This game is epic. I know you are not a big fan of the Ti-59 Gold, right? It is pretty much the same version which have a golden skin and it's a shining like baboon ass, okay? That's how the Ti-59 is looking like. But this battle itself, it's going to be focused what we are doing in the battle and how everything is going. And oh boy, wait until you are going to see the scores in this game. I mean what we did, what our team did, and what kind of base experience we had. I want to believe this is the best battle with a Ti-59, obviously. Without any doubts whatsoever, we are extremely lucky with a matchmaking right here, and we have like minus 2 matchmaking, unlucky tier 6s, but what can they do? They can go and not much what they can change there. Anyways, what we are going to do, I said that many times, I don't like Vali on this map, and I am feeling like I'm way more flexible in the city, so that's what we are doing, right? And once again, fellas, this is, by the way, speaking how enemies is starting the battle, looks like enemy team have a Russian submarine over there, which is called T-50/2. Hashtag never lucky for that guy. We are getting our first bits of damage right here, and this battle is going to be relatively slow, fellas. We will try to do the best actions, and hopefully everything will go well. As you can see, our top tiers, our top tier here is playing over there, T29 is playing over there. And what do we have in the city? We have a tier 6 shitter, we have the scout, which is a tier 6 scout, and we have us as a type 59, right? And we need to figure out how we can make some kind of how we can punish enemies for their stupidity. I'm going quite aggressively right here, and what we know, immediately we are getting hit by the Udas. Luckily he did not penetrate us, and this guy is sitting right there next to this building, so keep this in mind. And I'm thinking, can I make a hardcore pressure? Obviously Ruski tank did not manage to penetrate our gold skin, which is extremely good. And now I'm thinking, okay, what is the chances? Why am I retreating back over there? Look, I am pretty much only one top tier here, and this MX is not a big help for us. So I'm thinking, if I will go aggressively like this, IS-113, T-34-85, there, all of them is going to have a crossfire on me, and I cannot afford this. I just can't. So I'm trying to escape from here. I try to snapshot this Hellcat, but probably I was not yelling Russia loud enough, which is not very... which is okay. I mean, I can't complain, can I? And we spotted the T-150. Cheers, fellas. This is my morning coffee. So good morning if it is a morning where you are watching. So let's go. LTG is still sitting in the middle, and we try to blind fire him once or twice. Actually, after the blind shot, what we noticed right here, we noticed that the T-34 is camping, so Arta is penetrating him and eliminating him from the game on the full move, and this is going to be gorgeous. So look, this is, speaking about the Ti-59 as a tank itself, this tank is amazing lower tier killer. It has special matchmaking. And first question, is it worth 25,000 gold? Hell no, for obvious reasons. When we are, when we know the answer, what this tank is, this tank is the killer of the lower tiers. If you are playing against the tier 9s and you are thinking, you know, you are not super happy, I can tell you that playing against the tier 7s and tier 6s, you can feel like a king. And pay attention what we are doing right here. We are playing relatively well here. We are playing cooldown and we are shaking like crazy. And look at this Vaza. The hero of the day, Vaza. IS managed to penetrate our cupola, I assume that was cupola shot, and obviously he penetrated us, but it doesn't matter. Right there, we are going to have quite some fun. Cheers. As you can see, fellas, 112 is making a bit of pressure for us, and now we are saying, what's up, sir? How are you feeling? As you can see, fellas, by the loadout, unfortunately, I don't have too many AP shots, but I can tell you that it's way better to have way lower amount of AP shots than lower amount of APCRs, and when you are dealing against the higher tiers like E75 or any other quite heavy tank, I would rather to have those APCRs. By the way, funny fact, after the game I changed loadout to 20 APCRs, so I will have more APs. Anyways, who cares about that? So far the start is very, very good. We have solid 3.2000 damage and 500 resisting damage, and we are just starting our battle. So this is pretty much ideal start for us. And what we are seeing in the city, our 40 TP is making a bit pressure right here, so I kind of want to go aggressively, and I want to eliminate this IS, and I want to eliminate this LTG for obvious reasons, right? Pay attention at that IS who's supposed to be dead, and indeed he is. And right here, fellas, I am trying to figure out what I'm supposed to do. What we noticed, he got hit by Arta and he got hit by Udes, which means Udes more likely sitting somewhere even, maybe over there. So, once again, I cannot be super brave because I can tell you that if enemies are going to swarm me, it's going to be end of the story and all progress which we did over there, it's going to be done finito. We have only half of the hit points left right here or tiny touch, more than half, but it's not very good. Yes, I'm seeing that 150, which is crossing through the middle, and it's fine, I'm feeling good. Now, this person is completely trapped over there, and I'm still trying to figure out how I could get more use of all this. Since the Hellcat was spotted over there last time, I am trying to go with some blind shots. We are getting some assisting damage of that T150, the damaging shot, into the side like this, and I'm expecting our sniper Schnitzels to take care of him, but that was exactly the case what happened. So, look, so far, 3,500 damage, 800 assisting damage, score 7-7. Oh boy, I missed that kind of battles in the World of Tanks. I truly missed that kind of games. And you know what is the best part of all this? In my opinion, the Russian server can offer more of those battles, and recently I played quite a bit on the Rus server, and there is way more battles which is equal there, so I can tell you that I'm in love with Rus server, fellas. Anyways, and in L and in NAS server, a lot of battles are one-gated, 15-5, 5-15, and everything is turning around like this, so yeah. Well, hashtag never lucky us mortals, we cannot change anything. Anyways, let's go back into the game and look at this LTG. We are going to bully him a bit right here. So, LTG, I hope you are feeling good. LTG is going in front for us and we are gently touching him like this. LTG is saying, I have APCRs. I had an APCRs right here because I don't have APs left, and we finished him off with a high explosive for obvious reasons. So, 2 kills, 4,100 damage, and 100 assisting damage. Now, let's try to figure out where enemy team is. Progetto is spotted over there, hip hip hooray. Hellcat is over there, Udes is somewhere over there. Let's see. So, 12244 is not spotted. Since there is only one person which is not spotted, I am thinking a bit making more pressure right here. I have high explosive loaded, and I am thinking, should I go very aggressively or not? Maybe blind shot for a Hellcat. Unfortunately, that was not the case, and we did not manage to hit the shot. Meanwhile, fellas, if you would pay attention, we have a very solid scout which is spotting quite well over there. And you know what? Speaking of this scout is going to make a pressure together with us. At least that's what I think, and it looks like he noticed that. Anyways, before this scout will arrive, we can think about peeking on the corner here and maybe we are going to spot someone. Maybe we will spot that Sue, Udes, the same Hellcat. You never know. I'm trying to figure out. Maybe. Unfortunately, it is not the case, and I can't see shit. And our scout is pir. He's arriving. Obviously, I'm paying attention at the max map, and this is the main reason why the size of the map is that big. Okay, I don't want to miss anything. I can't imagine myself playing with a map like this. I just can't, fellas. And look what happened right there. Our T21, which was passive for all battle, he decided to go in front aggressively. And what kind of situation we have? We have the Udes. I'm thinking, should I go like this? And I immediately remembered what happened to that guy. Puts Arta in the face, so no. Think, fellas, think. What we can do, we are trying to flank the Udes like this. Ah, by the way, fellas, from now on, this golden tank have only gold ammunition, so don't you dare to complain. Obviously, if, I can tell you that, if I would have, if I would have the standard shots, more likely I would shoot them, but it is how it is. And I'm not complaining about that, don't get me wrong. That kind of battles is happening very, very rarely, so think about it. 5,000 damage in the tier 6 matchmaking, where the hit points pool in general is not very good, so keep this in mind. Anyways, fellas, what do we want to do now? Now, obviously, we are making a bit pressure for the enemies, and we are thinking, tasty Artas. That's what I am currently thinking. I have 300 hit points, so more likely I'm not going to be one-shottable for Arta. I think Clickers needs to hit me at least twice. At least that's what I think. So I am feeling relatively brave over there. But there is a dark side. The Progetto, obviously, who can two shot us or one shot if he is lucky. And in the same time, there is Sue. So what happened right there? We managed to hit the M44, and there is almighty Crusader SP, which is going to die. And right there, the Sue is peeking on us, but you know what? We know what we are doing right there. We are trying to sit hold down as much as we can. Our Arta hit this guy over there, and with the APCRs, oh boy, to deal with a Sue 1-2 is not a big problem by any means, fellas. It's not a big problem. Look, Progetto down to the one shot. Sue still have quite some hit points left. And first of all, I'm thinking about eliminating this Progetto for obvious reasons. I don't want this guy to flank us. Snap into the side, and obviously we are missing the shot. Well, what can we do? I did not did the things properly. I did not yell rush, I yelled snap. But it's okay, it doesn't matter. So 1-2, 4-4 is going down, and now my main mission is to get rid of the almighty Progetto, right? So we are going for the Progetto right here. And Arta is going on Erhashem, but I am thinking only about the Progetto for obvious reasons. So I am trying to chase him. We have a police chase, if we can say so. He's playing with a Ferrari. He's going, but I have McLaren, so all good. I managed to get him in the side. All good, fellas. And now the end game situation. The Clicker, Iha 258 or whatever, which is playing with Arta. He have 2 kills. He clicked well. I'm trying to surprise him from this position over there, but oh boy, looks like he's prepared. And do I want to take the risk? Do I want to take the risk to go for him in this way? I'm thinking, no, I don't. I will try to flank him, and I will try to use my, let's say like that, RNG factor. We might one-shot him. Klurksht in the face, and he is dead. Look at this performance. Solid 6,000 damage right there. 1,000 assisting damage. 7 kills. Now, fellas, what you are going to see, quite beautiful base experience, and what we did compare to the team. So no hints right there. Let's roll the music, the relaxing music, and let's check the scores. Okay, thank you so much for watching, fellas. It was a big pleasure for me to make this replay, and I can tell you that, well, to make this video, and I can tell you that battles like this is not happening dying every day. Yes, I was lucky the tier 6, that was the tier 6 battle. But to have this kind of score in the tier 6 game, it is extremely rare, okay? And all decisions which we did right here, we played quite safe. But everything paid off, and that was just a Gucci game, okay? Anyways, fellas, thank you so much for watching. Scores in a second. See you soon. Peace.